Chapter 6, Introducing Exhaust Gas Recirculation, or EGR, to diesel engines in 2002. The air and exhaust handling system for these engines became more complicated. Before this, the EGR loop was not present. Displacement of the engine and the size of the turbocharger casings and wheels controlled the airflow. Adding a wastegate to the turbine housing increased the airflow range. Since diesel combustion functioned well with a wide range of air-to-fuel ratios, further air management was unnecessary. The tougher emissions control starting in 2002 changed all that. Adding EGR allowed control of the composition of the intake air gas in the intake manifold, and therefore more precise control of the combustion process. However, when EGR was flowing, you were taking some of the exhaust gas that would have gone through the turbocharger and routing it back to the intake manifold. This changed the amount of gas going through the turbine and looked like a smaller displacement engine to the turbocharger. For example, if you route one cylinder's gas back to the intake manifold, then the gas going to the turbo is only 5 cylinders worth instead of 6. This changes the amount of work created to spin the compressor side of the turbocharger, so the intake boost flow and pressure also change. When you look at these effects over the entire engine operating range, you find out that it becomes necessary to implement some kind of variable turbocharging arrangement. This is called variable geometry. The VG feature allows the turbocharger to compensate for the high variation in gas flows and pressures it will see throughout the different engine operating ranges. To make EGR gas flow from the exhaust manifold to the intake manifold pressure needs to be lower than the exhaust pressure. Before the addition of EGR, this situation was seldom the case, since it was better from a fuel economy standpoint to have exhaust pressures lower than intake pressures. Engine manufacturers have implemented these features in a variety of ways. One of the most common arrangements is with a single VG turbocharger. A VG turbocharger has variable vanes and/or flow passages inside the turbine housing that allows adjustments to the exhaust gas flow as it feeds into the turbine wheel. A wastegate, a device that bypasses exhaust gas around the turbine wheel, is another method to adjust the gas flows. With EGR engines, wastegates are most often used with a dual turbocharger arrangement rather than a single turbo. Now, if the engine has both variable turbocharging and an EGR valve, there are two devices that are being used to control the airflows and pressures in the engine air handling system that must work together at all times. To manage this, introducing sensors and sophisticated electronic controls help to control the air handling system to optimize emissions, engine performance, and fuel economy. Engine manufacturers have also introduced diagnostics to test if the system is working, to detect and compensate for equipment failures, and notify the vehicle operator when the system is not working. Some engine manufacturers have implanted other airflow control devices besides the EGR valve and VG turbochargers. These include the use of intake air throttles, bypass valves, and exhaust throttles. These devices are used to enhance the air handling system function in parts of the engine operation where just the EGR valve and turbo don't provide sufficient flexibility to control the airflow. Oftentimes, these devices drive higher amounts of EGR when needed to meet performance and emissions requirements. Sometimes, they help manage the engine after-treatment system, the diesel oxidation catalyst, particulate filter, and SCR system. Air handling equipment to the diesel engine has added a great deal of complexity and sophistication to the engine function and controls. However, this equipment has also led to a much cleaner environment.